Hello everyone, and welcome back to AppSecSchool, where we demystify the world of application security one lesson at a time. I'm your host, Louis from Pentester Lab, here to guide you today on a fascinating journey into library code review. Let's dive right in. In our previous video, we covered how to review patches. Once you've got your hands dirty with a few patches, it's worth moving to libraries. Picking a library that you know or frequently use is the ideal starting point. It's essential to choose a format or protocol you are comfortable with, as this makes it much easier to spot the entry points. And hey, if you have done a few Pentester Lab exercises on JWT, why not start with a JWT library? Now, if the format is new to you, it's absolutely fine. Take your time to learn it before you jump into reviewing. Remember, as you practice more code review, you will be able to decipher formats just by looking at the code. It's a great tip to have a sequence diagram handy, especially when reviewing a library used for a protocol. It helps you understand quickly which step of the protocol you are at during your review process. As you start reviewing, it's crucial to know how to debug the library. Good old printf debugging could be your trusty companion at this stage. Make sure to run the code in the library. It's all about making your learning process easier. Don't get caught up trying to do a pure code review without running the code. Let's keep it practical and efficient. Now, let's talk about tracking the code flow. List down the entry points where functions or methods will interact with user control data. For example, if you are reviewing a JWT library, the full token will be user controlled. Follow the flow without focusing on finding bugs yet. The goal, understanding what is happening. It's all about observation here. Spot potential weaknesses and note them down. Be keen on the checks the developers implemented to prevent certain actions. This isn't the time to explore if the code is exploitable. We are gathering information here. Once you are comfortable with one library, find another one that does the same thing, ideally in the same language. Apply what you learned from reviewing the first library. This time, it will be a bit easier, I promise. And now for the exciting part. It's time to play spot the difference. Compare what is done similarly or differently between the two libraries. Observe how the checks are performed. Sometimes a small change, like uppercasing the data, can have a huge impact on security. After reviewing a couple of libraries, venture into exploring more. Remember, success here isn't measured by the number of vulnerabilities you find, but by what you learned about code organization, patterns, and security check structures. As you evolve, diving into gray box testing can be a thrilling next step to understand exploitability. It's a continuous dance between code review and gray box testing, moving from one to another whenever you feel stuck to enhance your understanding. And that brings us to the end of this video. Keep practicing, and remember, there are numerous undiscovered vulnerabilities waiting to be found. If you enjoy this video, make sure you share it. Until next time, keep learning and stay curious.